I'll tell you what, I'll have to get that trucking album that you've got.
Oh yeah.
I know. I
do. Do you play some vinyl? Do you play any vinyl here?
Well, yeah, we got a turntable.
Oh.
I don't usually bring stuff in, but I mean, if it's something that's history, I'll bring it in.
The cover of that album, we went out to that Richmond truck stop.
Yeah.
RJ set it up. We went out there and took some pictures in the parking lot with the big trucks behind me. And at the time, RJ's stepson, who was only 18 at the time, but he wasn't his stepson yet. But we used him. He had a, somebody had a dog.
Somebody brought a dog. I think the photographer brought a dog.
No, we got it from out there. Was it Lackey?
And you're right. God, you're good.
Lackey, wasn't it? Out there in close to Alexandria.
Yep.
And had a big old shepherd dog. Well, I got a song on the Trucker's album about old Ben. It's a recitation about a boy and his dog hiding away in the back of a semi truck, in the trailer. Okay. He hid away, then he got caught in there, and the little boy told him, said, "You can tan my hide if you've a mind, but please don't hurt old Ben."
that's good. That kind of reminds me of Elvis's song, Old Shep.
Yeah, it's kind of, yeah.
You know, he had to put him down.
Old Shep was, who did that originally? Was it Eddie Arnold or somebody?
I don't know.
The original Old Shep.
Yeah.
Seemed like Eddie Arnold or somebody. Recitation thing.
Yeah, Elvis did it, and the first time he did it was in the talent show at school.
Yeah.
That was the first time that he had done it. You know, as a teenager, you know, and he didn't win.
Who was it? Hag wrote a song about Tommy Collins. That the song's called Leonard.
Leonard
Sykes was Tommy Collins' name.
Yeah.
And they did and in the song that Haggard wrote about Tommy Collins. Said once he even followed Elvis Presley.
That's right. I have that song. In fact, I had that song downloaded for me by my good friend because I believe your wife Denise loves it.
Oh, she loves that song. Yes, Denise loves it. And usually about the end of the night or something, she'll get our Brandon and
have him play Leonard.
The DJ does the karaoke.
Yeah,
Brandon Morris.
Yeah, yeah.
And she'll have him to play Leonard. It's just a great song.
Oh, it is.
Haggard put it together so masterfully.
Yeah.
Wow. There's lines in there that you can believe. He said he had to write a song about old Tommy.
Yeah.
If just to see the smiling faces in the band.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Yeah, I mean, country music, real country music, that's the way I phrase it, is stories. And you can't beat, in my opinion, real, true stories about America.
Yeah. I sang one of Tommy Collins' songs in a talent contest when I was small. The first talent contest I sang in at the Trinity School, which was a bordering school, not the school that I went to. I went to Covedale grade school, but there was in the community, another community, Trinity School, and they had a Halloween social and they had a talent contest going on. So Mom gets this idea to take me down there and have me sing that contest. And I sung Your Cheating Heart in that contest.
Hank Williams.
It was out new then. I was 4 years old.
Wow.
And it scared me to death. The crowd stomped their feet and whistled and hollered and carried on. Scared me to death. And I was standing on stage after I got done singing. Mom had stood me there and then backed off. And then when it was over and the crowd was going crazy, Mom come walking up and I jumped about 5 feet before she got there and grabbed her around the neck and buried my head. And I remember Mom whispering in my ear, she said, "That's because they love you. They're doing it because they like you."
Yeah.
So But anyway, I started to tell a song about singing atomic. A few years later, they had the contest every year. A couple of years later, I sung the Tommy Collins song.
Keep talking.
Remember the Tommy Collins song, You Just Better Not Do That?
Yep.
That's what I sung.
Gonna find Leonard here.
Yeah, keep talking.
She said, why? And I said, cause you just better not do that. You got Leonard there? Oh, we're gonna hear it. And lot, you know, you folks out there, if you've heard, you probably heard this song, but you didn't really know, if you didn't listen carefully, you wouldn't know where the song come from or what it's about. But Merle Haggard wrote it about one of his heroes, Tommy Collins. And I love the line in there, said, talking about Leonard. And he called him Leonard, but it was Tommy Collins he was singing about. So most people wouldn't know the difference there. But he said once he even brought around a bag of groceries.
Gotcha.
Back before Muskogee came along.
Well,
can you see that?
Yeah.
I love
that. Well, those guys back then, they lived a completely different existence than country does today. You know, I mean, if you go back into the into the 50s, even starting with country and then rockabilly music, you know, everybody was traveling in a car. Nobody knew what a bus was.
Yeah, you can really figure when you listen to this song, listen to how Merle Haggard put it together, you can just see these things happening. They actually happen.
Yeah, yeah. No. So here's Leonard by the late, great Mr. Merle Haggard.
Was 21 years old, as I recall. He loved to write a song and pick the guitar, and he came to hang the gold one on the wall. The town which he lived is not important. You know which town I mean, the town I'm through. He soon became a famous entertainer, but Leonard was a name he never used. He was on his way to having what he wanted, just about as close as one could be. And once he even followed Elvis Presley, and he wrote a lot of country songs for me. But he laid it all aside to follow Jesus. For years he chose to let his music go. But preaching wasn't really meant for Leonard.
How in the hell was Leonard supposed to know?
How in the hell was Leonard supposed to know? Well, life began to twist its way around him, and I wondered how he carried such a load. He came back again to try his luck in music.
Lost his wife and family.
And lost his wife and family on the road. After that, he seemed to bog down even deeper. And I saw what booze and pills could really do. And I wondered if I'd ever see him sober.
I forgot about a friend
that Leonard knew. Well, Leonard gave me lots of inspiration. He helped teach me how to write a country song.
Listen to this.
And he even brought around a bag of groceries. Back before Muskogee came along.
What a master. Put his song together.
The town in which this episode began. Somehow I had to write a song.
Old timey.
If just to see the smiling faces in the band. Well, when Leonard finally came to California, 21 years old, as I recall. And he loved to write a song and pick the guitar. And he came to hang the gold one on the wall.
Oh. Great, great story. Great poet is Merle Haggard.
Did that paint a picture?
Yeah. I love that song, and I believe it was the first time that I had known about that song was you, when you were here one day and you were talking about Tommy Collins.
Oh, okay.
Maybe on a jam. Might have been one of the jams, and so I made some contacts because I didn't have it in my collection at the house, and so I got it, and I knew that your wife Denise.
Well, she's been after me for a long time to learn the song and do it. But it, you know, one thing, it's not a good dance tune, which don't matter. A good song's a good song, but it's not a good dance tune. And I know about every line in it, but I don't know how they fit together.
Well, anyway, don't ask me, because I can't tell you.
I would love to do it. I'd love to do the song because I feel the song and I know the story. So
yeah,
but it's just one of those songs I've just never taken the time to commit it to memory.
You know, I believe that would be a song that you would knock out of the park.
Yeah, and it's an entertaining song.
Yes.
If it's not a dance song, it's an entertaining song.
Yes.
At least.
Yes. Because, you know, people listen. I mean, you know, people come to our nightclub and they come to dance, they come to have a good time, but they listen. You know, I do. I mean, maybe I'm an exception, but I don't really think so. I think a lot of people sit and they enjoy the band and they listen to what songs the band is playing.
I've learned an old Merle Haggard song since we've been off. I've learned a little way back in one of the early albums. A friend of mine had been coaxing me to, you gotta learn this song, this old Merle Haggard song, you can do it great. Well, I pulled it out, got the words to it and learned it. It's called I'll Look Over You. I'll Look Over Things You Do.
Okay.
But the melody's great, and I remembered the song when Merle first came out with that album.
Okay.
And I was kind of familiar with it from here years ago, but I put it together, probably gonna start doing that.
Well, you love your Merle Haggard.
Yeah.
We all love Merle Haggard, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I was blessed to get to see him, you know, three times. You know, first time down at Coyotes, down there at Drawbridge.
Yeah.
You know, he
I
came
was there
in,
that night.
Yeah, he came in. You know, I was down there.
I was
know,
there that night.
But you didn't know me, and I didn't know you.
I was there, and we saw him at was it Music Hall? Was you down at Music
Hall?
Taft. I always get him confused.
Taft Theater.
Taft Theater, last time he was there.
Yeah. That was on my birthday.
Oh, okay. So it was June 25th, how many years ago?
2012, maybe.
It's been
2012.
Sue and I were together, and she got me the tickets for my birthday.
Yeah.
And we went down, and that was, I think the first real country show that she attended.
Oh.
She wasn't really, really huge.
And Merle hadn't missed a step. He was as good as he ever was then.
And
she still was that good.
And she said to me that night, Bobby, she said, Tom, amazing. Look at the audience here. A lot of young people, and they know every song.
When he'd kick off a song, everybody would know what it was going to be before he started singing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a great show.
Oh, yeah.
He got a little upset with the monitors being too loud. I'm usually upset because they ain't loud enough. but do you remember that?
Mm-hmm. I do.
I don't remember that.
He called the guy that was running the monitors on stage. He said, Come over here. Well, stand here where I'm at. Can you hear how loud that is? And one time he had that derby hat on. He pulled that hat off and threw it to the floor. You remember that?
Yeah.
It was classic.
Yeah. It, you know, he.
If I ever wore a hat, I'd probably done that. Never did wear one.
Yeah, well, you got me to wear a hat though.
I know.
that 22-gallon hat that I wear that I can't see my face in. Mm-hmm. But anyway, yeah, and then he also played down at the Lawrenceburg Entertainment Center Convention Center.
We were down at Lawrenceburg.
Hey, you played a show there.
Played a couple of them.
Bob Hudson set up for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a very nice setup.
Yeah, they escorted us in and out of town, didn't they?
Oh, that's right, yeah. Yeah,
saw Lori Morgan down there on a Christmas show.
Wow.
Oh. I'm trying to think who was there.
Diffie.
Joe Diffie.
And I never got to see him.
We opened for that show, right?
Did you?
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, that's really, really cool. I mean, but you got a lot of history, Bobby.
Yeah, a lot of miles.
Well, you got a lot of miles, but you got a lot of history. You
I'd
know?
Do it all over again.
Well, I know you would. I know you would, you know, because you love it. You know?
Yeah.
What else we got to chat about here? It's 12:15. I don't know what you want to do. If you want to hang, or if you and RJ want to go, that's entirely up to you.
Yeah, we can.